Take, for instance, last week. A woman's going to visit her mother. She has a bag of groceries and a bouquet of flowers to brighten up the place.
Mom? Mom? Mom?
What she doesn't know is 3 days prior, her mother's fallen off a footstool in the kitchen, busted her head open, and broken her neck. By the time she gets there, mother's body is bloated with bacterial gases. There's fluids leaking from her eyes, ears, nose, mouth. You get the picture. Well, death is tragic. But it's also big business. Some people deal with it spiritually. Others deal with it legally. But what most people don't know is that when someone dies in your house, it's up to you to clean up the mess. Well, sure, the city will come and take the body away. But what they leave behind is your own personal little souvenir. Now, most people don't have the stomach for that. That's where I come in. Now, cleaning a body is actually a lot like cleaning any other household spill. There are three basic steps. First, you get rid of all the bugs. HIV, herpes, tuberculosis, adenovirus, hantavirus, E. coli. Now, I assume all those things are present, so I spray everything with my own personal little cocktail of antivirals and disinfectants. And just between you and me, I also throw in a little Listerine, the original flavor. There's an enzyme that liquefies coagulated blood. You gotta use the original flavor, though, not that new blue or orange shit.
Well, Tom, that's, I'll be right back.